Park.
Well, fans, the crowd's still stirring here. They like the excitement of the wrestling at the Spectrum, and they're seeing it tonight. We got a great card. We've got Captain Lou Albano returning against Rick Martel. This is a grudge match. We've got the Moondogs, Rex and Spot, going against Dominic DeLucci, S.D. Jones, Magnificent Morocco, and Pedro Morales later on. George Steele, the Animal, returns tonight against Bob Backlund at the Spectrum. So now coming toward the ring, you see that's the Baron, Miguel Sacluna. And checking there on the left as you're watching the screen is Strong Kobayashi, the gentleman from Japan. Kick off his sandals now. And you're ready to do battle against another ring veteran, Baron Miguel Sacluna. And you talk about nasty. They wrote the book when they won on Sacluna when they said nasty. To point out the third man in the squared circle, of course, is well-known, well-beloved Dick Worley. Okay, lots of action coming up now. We've got Strong Kobayashi, who wrestles in his bare feet, and he uses them to great advantage, but he's basically a very fine scientific wrestler. Dick Worley, of course, brooks no nonsense in the ring. Kobayashi was introduced. Now we get the introduction on the Baron. All right, about 260 pounds of meanness. And Sacluna uses questionable methods at times to gain an advantage over his adversary. I like those words, fans. But right now, Sacluna is being checked over by Dick Worley, but usually somewhere on him, and only so many places to hide it, he usually has a foreign object. We'll be watching for that tonight as usual. But he's very clever with it. There's the bell, and the two get ready to get underway. Kobayashi, we've seen numerous times here at the Spectrum, comes to wrestle, shows a great deal. And Sacluna not even holding back. He gives a knee to the back and a chop to the throat on Kobayashi. Oh, there's a hip roll, and down goes Kobayashi, and some pressure being applied on the windpipe of Kobayashi by Sacluna. And a kick to the head, rolls the foot off the top of the head just to get the man's attention. Kobayashi really is a fine wrestler. We don't see him quite often enough. That's a personal observation, because he's really very fine. Knows all the holds, a great athlete. So we're always welcoming back here at the Spectrum. And there's more viciousness going on with Sacluna applying pressure, his foot, and old body pressure on the neck of Kobayashi. Backs him into the corner now. And they'll have to break it up. Dick Worley's saying break, but they still, oh! Pulling the nails across the eyes of Kobayashi is. And there goes that foreign object. Here we go again. Dick Worley checking out the body of Sacluna. Sacluna shoves him, and you know Worley, he won't tolerate that for a second. But the foreign object back in the hand of Sacluna, who hides it very, very well. And he gives a shot to the head on Kobayashi. He shoots him again, and the foreign object out of the hands now, back in the trunks. Now you talk about a guy like Sacluna. A lot of people boo him. I have a great admiration for him. He's a great athlete. And I don't know that really he has to use a foreign object to gain his advantage, but he seems to think he does. But he's a fine athlete. And Kobayashi's learning right now. Now he gives him a kick to the head. Now a slam to the head. Kobayashi's starting to retaliate. Down goes Sacluna. Oh. He gives him kicks to the face while spreading the legs. Those feet are weapons as far as that Japanese wrestler is concerned. He gives him a shot in the head again with that foreign object back in the tights, and he swears to Dick Worley it was an open fist, open hand rather. No fist at all. Of course, a lot of the ringside is no better. And kicks Kobayashi, who's actually under the bottom rope and out on the apron. So they've got to break this off, although Cicluna won't listen. Count of three on him, and Worley warns him back. Smash to the back, the upper shoulder right between the blades by Cicluna. And that was a fist that time, no open hand. Cicluna smashes the head down. Ooh. Coming another smash to the... Oh! Ooh! All right, Cicluna. Cicluna being faked out there by Kobayashi. And he, a series of smashes on Cicluna as he's helpless, tied up in the ropes. And he's giving it to him. So it's payback time, fans. Payback time. Well, the fans here liking it as Kobayashi gets the upper hand momentarily, but he gets a kick to the face by Cicluna. Down he goes. Oh, he rubs that foot, the rubber sole of his foot, right across the eyes of Kobayashi. Into the ring ropes and takes a... he took a knee to the midsection. Down he goes again. Maybe for a pin, I don't know, but he kicks out. Kobayashi, clearly the lighter of the two, though he's no lightweight at all. Oh! We have seen that one three times tonight. There's the pin, and it's all over, just like that. Woo! Kobayashi, that fast, gained the advantage, and down went Cicluna in the pin position, and it's all over, fans. All right. All right, 4 minutes, 38 seconds, and you've got your winner, Strong Kobayashi, over the Baron, Miguel Cicluna. Cicluna still carrying on. He's trying to make his point with referee Dick Worley. Worley shoves him back and says, I don't want any parts of you. Leave me alone. Kobayashi kind of defending Dick Worley, too. But it's all over. Let's go to your screen wherever you're watching tonight, at home perhaps, fans, or at your favorite pub, and check it now as we see Strong Kobayashi going to the ring, and he's jammed in there. He swings aside. The Baron goes into the ring, turnbuckles. Down he goes, and a nice positioning by Kobayashi. He gets the pin, and that's that. So there you have it. Wowee. All right, fans. Returning to Prism in July is Close Encounters of the Third Kind Special Edition, starring Richard Dreyfuss.
Great, Allegheny, triple four, turn right, 30 degrees.
Get on the order of the 45th recon away. See what the hell they could be testing up there.
They're moving. Right by it, right now.
Ask them if you want to report a face.
PWA 517, do you want to report a UFO? Over. PWA 517, do you want to report a UFO? Over.
4 down, 5 8, the altitude.
5-8, Close Encounters of the First Kind. Sighting of an unidentified flying object. Close Encounters of the Second Kind. Physical evidence of a UFO. Close Encounters of the Third Kind. Actual contact. Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
All right, back at ringside here at the Spectrum, fans, and thank you very much for being with us tonight, wherever you're watching Prism on a hot, muggy Saturday night. If you're missing the action, you'd like to be here, well, I'm sure we'll have wrestling next month. We don't know the date yet, but we'll be back along to talk about that a little later on. August 1st, huh? We're informed August 1st is the next wrestling date here at the Spectrum. We do urge you to watch it on Prism Television, of course, but it's great to be here in person to catch all the in-Spectrum excitement. All right, tonight so far we've seen Johnny Rods take Kurt Hennig. And he gave Herning a real wrestling lesson, as I think you saw. Secondly, we had Larry Sharp going against Tony Altimore. You had Larry Sharp as a local guy. He's from across the river over in Jersey, and he comes to wrestle. Anytime you see him, he really does it. And on top of that, we had Tony Altimore, who's been around the ring circles for a long time and had a lot of good moves, but he kind of got worked over in that one shoulder and found out he couldn't bail out. He just didn't have the full strength that he wanted. So that's what happened there. And then, of course, we had Mikel Cicluna just wind up against Strong Kobayashi. He gave it pretty good to Kobayashi for a while, but then finally Strong Kobayashi prevailed. He pinned in about four, on just under 5 minutes, he pinned the Baron, and that was that. Tonight we really have a sensational wrestling show for you. Now I'm going to lead up to this, the main, what we call really the main event, Bob Backlund and his opponent. We'll get to that in a few minutes. Tonight we have a special grudge match, and that'll be Captain Lou Albano going against Rick Martel. This has been a grudge match since last month, and they're finally going to collide here at the Spectrum tonight, and anything can happen. We also have the magnificent Morocco from Sunset Beach out in Hawaii. He's going to go against the very popular wrestler, the champion, continental champion, Pedro Morales from San Juan, Puerto Rico, our amigo. Then, of course, we have also Sergeant Slaughter, Rick McGraw. That'll be coming along tonight. Sergeant Slaughter is our interview tonight in intermission time. You might see a little bit of a different side of Slaughter. You see kind of one side of him in the ring. Here's a little bit of a different angle on Slaughter, our special halftime interview. You'll see that before very long. Of course, we've got the Moondogs, Rex and Spot, going against Dominic DiNucci. Happy, good, go lucky Dominic DiNucci and SD Jones. SD Jones, a local fella, and everybody loves him. And of course, the main event, Bob Backlund. He better be ready tonight because George the Animal Steele returns here to the Spectrum. Haven't seen him in about a year, and he's back tonight, folks. And I don't know, anything can happen if you remember George Steele. So the Animal will be here, you're here, we're here. Come on, let's go to ringside again. We turn our attention as the principals for the next event come on, and we'll check them out now. We've got the next angle here. And this, my friends, is King Kong Muska, and he's going against the Hollywood Glamour Boy, I call him. I kid him about this. He's just so handsome, you can't stand it, and the girls love him. It's Tony Garea. Just told me he just returned recently from New Zealand again. Takes a quick trip over there periodically. Nicely tanned is Tony. I kid him about that. I said, hey, you spending more time on the beach? You are on the wrestling ring? He says, no way. But I try to hit the beach, get a little tan once. Look at that face. Look at that face, huh? Ladies, look at that. Ooh, look at that. I told last month I'd be his agent anytime you want to go to Hollywood. What a great guy, too. Tony Garea, very, very slowly approaching the side of the ring. He's keeping an eye on this guy. There's no way he wants to take his eye off King Kong Muska. Muska's involved haranguing the fans. Yeah, I'm just reminded, he was a Canadian football player. We saw him wrestling over at Highland Park High School in New Jersey a couple of weeks, about 10 days ago. And he's something else. Big. Well, the fans are kind of taking off after King Kong Muska, and let's take off after Gary Capetta. Get the introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for 1:12 with a 20-minute time limit.
Okay, having a little difficulty with the PA tonight, fans, so we'll fill in the gaps here a little bit. All right, from Toronto, Canada, King Kong Muska, the former Canadian football star. And he's big and mean. And now we point over to the other corner to your left. There he is, Glamour Boy himself, and a heck of a nice guy, a great wrestler, Tony Garea. And everybody loves him. The whole place comes alive when they hear his name. The fans love him here in Philadelphia and wherever he travels to wrestle. All right, they're getting the last minute instructions from Dusty Feldbaumer. These guys doing a psych job on one another, not taking their eyes off one another. All right. Look at that, staring contest. Muska looks aside at the fans. They're haranguing him, still bugging him. Uh-oh. There they go. We're right back as kids again. You push me, I'll push you. But look, Gurria is just staring him down. Look at right in the face. We haven't seen this, I'll tell you, in a long, long time, fans. Look at it. Uh-oh. Whoa! Fans are loving it. Listen to them come alive tonight, fans. Whew. Mosk is delivering some kind of warning to Gurria. Gurria's not buying anything. He understands. But on a kick, and down goes Mosca. All right, Gurria is upset. There's a count on Mosca now. King Kong is upset, Tony Gurria. Gurria says, come on to the center, let's get it on. You threw down the glove on me, you threw down the gauntlet, now let's get it on, boy. I wouldn't want to be between either one of those guys tonight. Well, we have a clean break coming up here on the. They're still at it. Look at him. Uh-oh. He hair pull on. And he gives a hair pull, too. And there they go back and forth around the ring. Look at this, fans. We've never seen this before. And a punch coming up. Oh! Gurria blocks the punch. He delivers a punch, and down goes Mosca. And that's. Woo! Tell you, the fans are coming alive. Gurria is every inch a match for King Kong Mosca tonight. Look at him. He says, come on. Come to me in the center of the ring. Just you and me. Very agile, both these athletes. Now they connect again. And an arm bar. Pressure on the arm of Gurria by Mosca. Mosca with a superior body weight. I know about strength. We'll find out before long, I guess. And a lot of pressure on the upper arm, the shoulder area of Gurria by Mosca. Gurria's close to going down. He's almost down on one knee, but he gets back up again. Look, what strength and endurance he has. Gurria trying to turn it around and get Mosca down. And there goes the hair pull. And he's trying to kick out of it. He's back on his feet. And there's another hair pull, and down goes Gurria. Hey, referee! Mosca calling for the referee to bail him out. He takes a couple of shots. Forearms to the neck. And, whoa! Gurria now changes it around. Dusty Feldbaumer looking in the face of King Kong Mosca saying, what about it? Meaning you concede. Gurria adding a lot of pressure to that arm and shoulder area. Just keeping the twist up, making those muscles go in places they've never been before. Mosca trying to break it into the corner, and there we go. For the fourth time tonight, we've seen the same thing. That arm crashing down to the upper shoulder area by Gurria. And Mosca takes more of a beating. Down he goes. He's in pain. He's slapping that canvas. You can hear him. Oh, he is in super pain. There's Gurria, clearly in control right now. Still applying pressure. Gurria still holding on. Mosca swinging at trying to punch the upper shoulder. I think he's trying to get some blood going. And he wants to swing back at Gurria. Gurria gives it to him. Gurria comes right off back with it. And he's in control of that arm again. Twisting. Twisting some more. Oh, Gurria makes like he's got to kick him with his knee or his foot in the ribs, but doesn't. He's just shaking that arm. Look at him. Gurria just shaking up and down, the crowd counting a cadence with him. The crowd clearly on the side of Gurria tonight, as you might expect. King Kong Mosca where he's a great athlete, he's not that popular in the Philadelphia area tonight, I'll tell you that. Bosca trying to drive Gurria back, but Gurria won't hold. He won't break that hold, still maintaining pressure. Now we got Gurria going in the ropes, and a body shoulder block, and down goes Bosca, and a takedown. Nice roll. There he goes, right back with that pressure on the arm again. This could be a deciding factor tonight, fans, because Bosca, this continues, will have no feeling in his arm if indeed he has any feeling in his arm right now. Because Gurria has been working on that arm minute after minute. I'm telling you, fans, not the needle nose. If you're not here at the Spectrum tonight, if you're not here, you're missing a lot of good action. I know you're watching it on Prism TV, wherever you are. But boy, being here is dynamite. So come on down August 1st. That's when we're here again. We'll hear about that program coming up later on tonight. I can't wait to hear who's going to be here, fans. All right, there's a kick, and Bosca down again. Gurria clearly in control, and another beautiful takedown and control of the arm. Pressure being exerted again by Gurria. He's got him. Gurria's really maintaining. Look, still, he can move. He'll stand him up, but he still got that pressure on him. Hot and humid as the night is, wrestling fans were standing at the ticket windows waiting to get in here tonight, fans. They can't wait to see their favorite wrestling, Worldwide Wrestling Federation, as it's here at the Spectrum every month. Gurria goes down. He's stunned right now, half leaning against the lower two ropes of the side of the ring, but he's somewhere else. And Bosca jumps on him. Clearly, he's in control now, but still favoring his left arm and shoulder. Gurria taking more of a beating. He gives it back again. He gets it. He gives it. Gets it. Gives it. And now Mosca's on the short end. Whoa! And down again he goes. And there's more pressure on the arm. He goes. Now he's putting pressure on the throat area of Tony Gurria. Morocco going now. All stops are up. He's actually trying to. He's just pulling at the face of Tony Gurria with both hands. Now he gets a smash to the side of the head. Well, Gurria's getting that punishment back that he gave a while ago. Morocco right on top of him. That they're on the ropes. They're going to have to break. A count of two. Count of three. They break. Gurria very clearly in big trouble. Down he goes. And Baraka stomps on him. Baraka, of course, still favoring his arm. He's trying to get that blood circulation again. Foot comes in contact with the head of Gurria across the eyes, and he is really seeing stars. Smash to the head by Morocco. Gurria almost barely did. He does go down. He was just standing there hanging by a thread a moment ago. A knee to the head, and down he goes again. Morocco, he's a mauler. Down goes Gurria. Now across the eyes again. He's got the jaw. He's putting pressure on the jaw area. I don't know, Gurria, is he going to concede? Is he going to give up? Dusty Feldbaumer checks him. He's fighting it. We've seen this happen many times again where Gurria's been in total pain, and from somewhere he gets the strength to get back on his feet. Whether he can do it tonight or not, I don't know. Let's watch and see the pain, the pressure on his face by Morocco. Gurria receiving the cheers of the fans. They're urging him to get it on, get up. Look at the face. Oh, look at those faces, fans. And Gurria is still in bad, bad shape. He's on the short end of the and getting agony for his trouble.
Take his hand.
Morocco says, take his hand, shake his hand. And is there any life there? I don't know. Dusty Feldbaumer holds the end, drops it, and it just settles next to him on the The arms up. Oh, is he coming back? He's looking good. Gurria gathering strength again, and here he comes. Gets raked across the eyes by Morocco. Oh, he rolled out. He kicked Morocco, I thought was going to be pinned, but he kicked Gurria in the head. And we start all over again. Can your heart stand this pants? He smashes Gurria across the head. Tony really just barely knows where he is. And now the pressure being applied to the face area again by Morocco. Dusty Feldbarber warning Morocco about these tactics. Looks to be Gurria's right back where he was a little while ago. Hardly any movement at all. Wait, the arm's shaking. He's trying to regain his strength. But Moscow's not relieving any of the pain inflicted upon Tony Gurria. Look at the size of the hands of Morocco. Look at it. What a monster man he is. He is huge. Morocco's still applying pressure. Gurria's still almost totally out of it. Can he come back? I don't know. He's up on both knees, now on one knee. And goes for the midsection twice on Morocco. And there he rakes his eyes again. Hey, wait a minute. Two. Gurria almost twisted around and turned it. And he gives it. He's mad. Look at him. He's furious. Gurria coming down with an elbow smash. He's giving it to Morocco now. Into the, here he goes, the back body drop. Gurria comes down with a crash of the elbow on top of him. One, two, kicks him away. Oh, the fans came up in the air only to be let down again. There's a body slam. Whoa, Gurria down, one, two, three. You saw it. There it is, the decision. It could have gone either way. You saw that. Having to go the way of King Kong Moscow. Let's get the announcement. See if we can. All right. The fans responding. They don't like it a bit. King Kong Moscow clearly the winner by a pin over Tony Gurria. And the fans are hot. Hotter than the weather outside tonight. Tony Gurria going after Moscow, but he's won. So he's taking off. Gurria wants more of him. You saw a very unusual beginning to our match tonight. Gurria is just furious. He wants all of Moscow. He wants Moscow back in there again. And maybe we'll see it. The fans want it. The fans going crazy. Ew! Moscow started into the ring. When he saw Tony Gurria coming, he jumped out. Well, that seems to be that. Moscow going back to the dressing room, leaving very perplexed and very frustrated. Tony Gurria by himself getting the cheers of the crowd. All right, let's go to your set again, fans. Let's go to your fans as the fans cheer Gurria. He's thrown off by Moscow. I thought we had a pin going there. Gurria coming out of the ring now. As Gurria, as you see in the ring now on instant replay, a body slam coming up. And down goes. They roll over and Moscow right on top of Gurria. And here we get the pin, a one, a two, and three. He's gone. And that's it. That's the decision, like it or not. Moscow over Gurria. Well, the star, Dustin Hoffman. The director, Sam Peckinpah. The movie, Straw Dogs. And here are some scenes.
is David Sumner. All his life, he's been running away, turning his back on trouble, involvement, and confrontation. He took his wife and fled to an English country town.
There was once a time, Mrs. Sumner, when you were ready to beg me for it.
Take your hands off me.
He's an animal. He thought he could find peace and refuge. Instead, he found that a man can't hide forever.
I will not allow violence against this house.
There are five men out there.
I know that.
Sam Peckinpah unleashes Dustin Hoffman in Straw Dogs.
Okay, you hear the boos and some jeers of the crowd, not cheers especially. We're in the ring right now to your right, and up on the ring ropes, glaring at the crowd, is the next one of the next participants, and this is the magnificent Morocco from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, the challenger. He's going for that belt tonight, the Intercontinental belt, owned by Pedro Morales, the Puerto Rican champion. So here's, look at the size of this guy. He is... Boy, he blocks out the sun when he walks by. The magnificent Morocco. Here he comes, my amigo. Here he comes, Pedro, and the crowd responding in kind. He loves them, and they love him. Hey, amigo. Popular Pedro Morales. He's shaking hands as he came by a lot of the ringsiders to the ring. They love him. Great champion. Let's get the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next contest is for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship. It is set for one fall to a finish. Introducing first the challenger to my left, from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, 249 pounds, the magnificent Morocco.
There you heard the announcement, and Pedro Morales is in for a battle tonight. Morocco trying to get us started by pushing Pedro. Look at that belt, fans. Beautiful piece of jewelry. That's really what it is. Oh, Morocco! Morocco runs out of the ring. Morocco outside the ring. He ran from Pedro. Pedro runs from no man. Okay, there's the bell. They're underway. And Morocco trying some psychological ploy on Pedro. Pedro doesn't buy it. They're giving it to him. They're really coming after him. The fans really handing it to magnificent Morocco, the challenger. All right, he's clean. Referee checks the hands of Morocco. Now he has a grin on his face as if he knows something. All right, they make contact, and Pedro shoves him away. He's mad. He's got his Puerto Rican up tonight, fans. The fans really not liking Morocco even a slight bit. And now Pedro shoves him away again. Clearly a battle of strength tonight and psychology going on, too. Pedro, nobody's fool, and certainly quite a man. The holder of the Intercontinental Championship and the belt, which Morocco wants, of course. Fans at ringside handed it to him. They're needling Morocco. Seems very confident, though. Well set up, this guy from Hawaii. And he shoves him away again. The back body drop. And suddenly, Pedro taking it to him. Body slam. Woo! Well, there you see it. And there we've got a shot of the magnificent Morocco. Maybe not so magnificent right now. He's not liking this even a little bit. Very concerned now. Not very happy about the turn of events. Pedro being urged back by referee Savaldi. Yeah, here we go. Although as concerned as Morocco was a few minutes ago, he keeps needling the fans and now offers his hand. Wants to shake. Let's be friends. Pedro not buying that at all. All right, they mean business now. And a hair pull on Morocco, by Morocco on Pedro. Pedro starting to get beat around. And oh, he reverses. Takes the knee. Pedro goes down. Oh, oh, Pedro was ready. Savoldi warning Pedro to step back, give the man room, let him get inside the ring again. Pedro claps his hands together, says, I'm ready. He does it again. Morocco, he has to begin to wonder, did he do the right thing signing for this match tonight? Crowd gets quiet again. They're waiting to see the next bit of action. They're into it now. Side headlock by Morocco and Pedro. Morales takes it okay. I think he's pretty much in control, though. He's not too upset. Although that's pain on that head of his. Look at the arms on the Morocco. What a big, big guy he is. He is huge. Pedro shaking his fingers, says, no, no, I'm okay. Don't be concerned about Pedro. Ms. Morales' young man is okay, he says.
Come on, Morales, what do you say?
Morocco has a few choice words for folks at ringside tonight. They respond, of course. Pedro's still in a headlock, side headlock by Morocco. Pedro trying to break the hold, and I don't know. Battle of strength right now. He takes a knee to the midsection, which doesn't help matters, and a punch to the chin. Of course, that one thumb is all wrapped up, bound by adhesive tape. Savoldi, referee, checking under the neck area, make sure there's no chokehold on Pedro Morales by Magnificent Morocco. They're still going at it, and looks to be Pedro Morales is still in trouble. Here comes Morocco on a shoulder block, and down goes Morales. And the body slam, down he goes. Morales still in the clutches of Morocco. Referee's still right on the scene, checking for any chokehold. There seems to be none.
Come on, Crispa. Come on, Crispa.
Ooh.
Come on, Chris
Bracco is really handing it verbally to Morales. You can pick up some of the needling Bracco is giving to Pedro Morales as they are on the mat there, and Morales still not in bad shape. He warns that he's okay, says he's fine. In our excitement earlier, we were referring to King Kong Musk at times, I understand, as Morocco, and our apologies to the fans. We get a little carried away ourselves sometimes, so we just go along with it. We're fans too here at the Spectrum. Don't think we're not. So sometimes we do get carried away. Still Morocco with a pressure applied to the head of Morales. Morales still has not conceded. You ever see Morales concede or not, but Morocco is clearly in the driver's seat right now, applying more pressure all the time, grinding those arms around the side of the head of Morales. Well, the check to see if he wants to give in. You give up, Morales says no. I'm sure he's maybe thinking about it. A lot of pressure being applied there.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on, Morales.
Just a reminder, coming up at intermission, an interview with Sergeant Slaughter, also Prism Wrestling Fan of the Month, and wrestling ratings for the month of July. That's coming up at intermission, so don't miss it, fans, if you will stay right with us. All right, still Morocco applying that pressure to the side of the head on Morales, but he's up now. I don't know whether he figures a way of breaking that hold, but he's trying. And a battle of strength. Now Morales starting to apply pressure to the left arm, and the hair pulling down goes Morales again. Being warned by the referee to watch the hair pull. Those of you watching up in the Harrisburg area tonight, don't forget the Zimbo Mosque on Friday, July 10th at 8:30. It'll be magnificent Morocco, whom you're seeing right now. He'll be going in that on that program that night. Pedro Morales will be there, George the Animal Steel, Rick McGraw, Killer Khan, some new faces, Kurt Henning, whom you saw earlier tonight, Jack Carson from nearby Atlantic City, he'll be there, and so many others. Lots of the regular faces, the ones you know and love, and of course some new faces too. That'll be on Friday, July 10th at 8:30. That'll be at the Zimbo Mosque in Harrisburg. And I'll tell you, Morocco is still applying pressure on the champion, Pedro Morales. Delivers a kick to the rib section. Delivers a smash to the neck and goes back into more pressure on the neck area of Morales. Morales trying to gather the referee's attention. They're checking for any space there underneath the chin near the neck. Seems to be all right, but maybe there's some sort of a sleeper hold on to Morales right now. Morales is doing it. He's got one leg just shaking. Morales, one leg just shaking away. Morales instinctively brings one shoulder off the mat so there can be no pin at this time. Still Morales. Morales is down, not out yet. But the fans are yelling for Morales to get it together and get up. Both these guys are drenched tonight with sweat. You get your money's worth and then some tonight, fans, as Morales goes into the ropes and back with another headlock on Morales by Morocco. Morales down again. Looks like he's half out of it, fans. Maybe more than that, I don't know. Well, they're checking to make sure he's not totally out of it. Count of two. somewhere, somewhere inside of him. Morales twice now, pulls that one shoulder up, count of two, and ooh, almost a count of three, and he got his shoulder up. Now Morales trying for a hair pull. He'll do anything to get out of that because he's gonna do payback time. All right, the fans responding. Morales giving it back to Morocco now. Morales still down. And here comes a kick to the midsection by Morocco. Punch to the jaw. And here goes Morales. Whoa! And again. As we've seen so many times tonight. One wrestler with the advantage over the other and gets too eager. Goes right into the ring. Post. And here comes an elbow to the midsection of Morocco by Morales. Morales coming back now. He goes for the Morocco's eyes. And listen to the fans. Morales in action. Back body drop and down goes Morocco again. Woo! He gives him a shot alongside the head and outside the ring he goes and there he is. Morales outside. Take him over there. Morales. There goes the choke hold. Morales gives it to him. Go! Woo! Both the referee and Morocco go down. The referee underneath. Morales back in again. Here he goes. And a backbreaker. But the referee is down and out. Oh! Listen to the fans. Morales, suddenly it occurred to him that the referee is down, isn't seeing anything that's going on. Trying to help up the referee. He will. The count of one, two, and three. Woo! I don't know, fans. It looks to be. Maybe the unexpected has happened. We have what seems to be a new champion. There it is. Morocco has the belt. Let's get the announcement.
21 seconds, the winner and new Intercontinental Champion, the Magnificent Morocco.
We're trying to get a word with Pedro when he comes out. He has lost the belt tonight. We have a brand new Intercontinental Champion. Like it or not, Magnificent Morocco holds the belt just relinquished by Pedro Morales. We'll try to get a word with him. We can get him as he comes out of the ring tonight. He is still stunned and, of course, can't believe that he has lost the belt tonight. He's saying, no, no, no way. I can't have lost the belt. Pedro is still... He said, no, no, tell me it's not true. It can't be. The fans are with him. We're trying to get Pedro interview here. He's still pretty well stunned. He's just standing in the ring. I don't know whether he can come out or not. You need some help, maybe. Pedro, amigo. Pedro. Can you talk to us at all, Pedro? Pedro is kneeling next to our location here. He just cannot understand it, cannot accept the fact that the belt has changed hands tonight. Pedro. Can you talk to us, Pedro?
Oh, man, I never been hit like that before, sir. Oh.
Never been hit like that before.
Oh, man, I don't know what he hit me with. I never been hit that. Oh, I still dizzy.
All right, Pedro, can we look at the replay at all? Here you are, Pedro. Here it comes. You're helping up Savoldi, all right? You're helping up the referee.
Yeah.
Now.
Well, I figure he give up in there. I hear a scream, I give
right,
up.
Now you got hit. You got hit. He didn't see it, and you went down.
I never see that one before because I figure he was down, you know.
He didn't really have you in a pin situation, Pedro.
Oh, no. Oh, man, I can't believe it.
Pedro.
Can we expect
you to get that belt back, Pedro?
I don't know. Right now, I cannot think straight, sir.
Okay.
Oh, man.
All right, that's Pedro Morales. He lost the belt tonight to Magnificent Morocco in a pin. A little questionable, but nevertheless, the belt has changed hands. We'll be back with more here at the Spectrum in a moment, but here's some scenes from the Idolmaker this month on Prism.
You got that head turning, Walt, just talking about. Makes me want you again.
You got it, Tommy. I saw it in there. You know something? With the right handling, you can go all the way.
He'll teach you how to move.
All we gotta do is loosen it up and bring the talent up to match your face.
How to smile.
They want Prince Charming, you know? Somebody cute and safe.
How to sing.
I just want to take you where I'm going.
He'll tell you when to think.
I told you I want the movies for Tommy, not television. You got that?
When to talk.
From now on, you don't go nowhere. You don't leave this house. You don't do nothing.
When to love.
One of your star reporters was having an affair with one of the idols.
And if you're lucky, if you last, he'll make you a star.
It's all crazy, all of I did it. Yeah, I did it.
The Idol Maker. He could do it for you.
All right, Dick Graham here at the Spectrum on a Saturday night live, watching the action here as you are on Prism Television. And tonight we've got quick draw Rick McGraw coming in. He's in the ring right now, and your camera is focused on the other side of the Spectrum, waiting for, there he is, the arrival of Sergeant Slaughter. Okay, here we go now to ringside, and Dave Zinkoff. Rick McGraw.
Right hand time, gentlemen. This match, one fall with a 30-minute time limit from Charlotte, North Carolina, Red Trunks 234, Rick McGraw. His opponent with a campaign hat, boots, red, white, and blue again.
it, fans. The next event on our spectacular wrestling program tonight here at the Spectrum, Quick Draw Rick McGraw, clearly the shorter of the two, maybe the lesser of the two in weight. However, don't count him out at all, because this man has extraordinary moves, very, very quick, great strength, and a lot of heart. So Sergeant Slaughter now getting, use the whip on Rick McGraw, which could be a bad move. Rick McGraw grabs it and kicks the midsection. He decides to give it to him again. Rick McGraw underway at full steam. Here he goes. He's beating on Slaughter. McGraw is really taking it to him tonight, fans. Smashing his head into the top turnbuckle. Slaughter in trouble right off the bat. He's bleeding already. Oh, the blood. Oh. He's opened up. I don't know. This may not go very long, fans. Rick McGraw opened up the forehead of Sergeant Slaughter, and really, the blood's just running down his face like crazy. He doesn't even know where he is. He's punching at the air, as you can see. McGraw's right on top of him. And he takes another shot to the head. And into the turnbuckle. Back body drop, and down he goes. Count of one, two, and throws him off. I don't know where in the world that Slaughter got the strength, but he did. There's a headbutt by McGraw. Going for the midsection, then again the face. Woo! McGraw's outside the ring. There he is. You can see our location right below us. McGraw's stunned. He's covered by the blood of Slaughter. Slaughter right out for him. He's gone after him. They'll bring him down on it. Oh, he smashed his hand down. Rick McGraw's down. Here comes. Slaughter again, he's kicking at him. He's beating him down. And now, all right, he jams Rick Martel's head into the ring post, and down goes Rick McGraw. McGraw now finally back up to the ring apron. And Slaughter's starting to work on him. He wants him inside. And in. Oh! Suplex, and down they both go. Well, if you counted out Slaughter early, you were wrong. Here he comes back full strength. Rick McGraw on the short end. McGraw being punished severely by Sergeant Slaughter. He's not even paying attention to the fact he's bloodied. He's not even noticing that at all. He takes McGraw down. I'll tell you, fans, this has gotten off to a tremendous start tonight. 1-2. And Slaughter pulls McGraw up. He doesn't want any pin. He wants to beat him. He wants to really drive him into the canvas. Oh! McGraw ducks under. McGraw ducks under Slaughter, gets away from him for the time being. Now they're slugging one another. Slaughter doesn't even seem to be paying any attention to him. Here comes Slaughter with a knee drop and on the neck area of McGraw, and I'm telling you, fans, they are punishing one another tonight. McGraw going for the midsection briefly, but now he's up and, oh! do damage to the lower back area. McGraw, nothing else will. And I'll tell you, McGraw trying a kick out, but no way. There's not much strength there for the time being anyway. And here goes Slaughter, putting a move on him again. And there's a chop, and down goes McGraw. The whole side of the face is just covered with blood. That's the blood of Sergeant Slaughter. Yeah, he's in a daze, I'll tell you the truth. I think Slaughter Knight is wrestling and beating on McGraw out of pure instinct. He looks dazed. He's now just as aware of the crowd. I don't think he's even paying any attention to them. He kicks at the face of Rick McGraw. Kicks him again, and McGraw suddenly doesn't know where he is. This has been a match tonight, folks. Oh, and a pile driver. McGraw on the short end. Lou Super trying to warn Slaughter. But I'm telling you, I don't know who can stop this tonight. The bell, whenever it rings, or a pin. Slaughter is just beside himself. He's just cold. He's gone to the top of the ring ropes, comes down. Driving his foot onto Rick McGraw, again giving him a kick, kicks him again. McGraw trying to give him an elbow, anything to get out of this. He's being just shaken. Slaughter just with a headlock on Rick McGraw. McGraw just weakly sagging to the canvas. Lou Super, the referee, asking, you give up? McGraw, I think, seems to be totally out of it. Finally released by Slaughter. And Lou Super pushed by Slaughter. Down he goes. Slaughter back on top of McGraw again. Now the headlock. Squeezing him. Pulling at him. Punishing him. Lets him go. McGraw just falls down. And you notice something tonight. Slaughter is not, look at him. As far as he's concerned, I guess it's all over. But notice something about Slaughter tonight. He's not bragging.
5 minutes, 2 seconds. Winner, Sergeant Slaughter.
Slaughter tonight is not bragging at all. He didn't brag when he came in necessarily. He just wanted to punish McGraw and did so. Slaps his hands together as if to say, well, that's that. McGraw, on the other hand, is being administered to by Lou Super as you face the screen now, face the ring on the other side of the ring. And I don't know whether he'll need help to get out of the ring back to the dressing room. McGraw really has been in a battle tonight, as you saw. I haven't seen anybody being beaten around the way McGraw has by at the hands of Slaughter in a long, long time. I don't believe it. But Slaughter was cool. Slaughter was super cool tonight. Okay, fans, if your heart can take it, let's check it. Here we go. Here we lead up to the events before the decision. There goes McGraw down and pretty much out. He's coming from the ring now. He's being helped out of the ring by Lou Supa. Supa's asking, do you give up? Slaughter will not concede at all. He wants to maintain that pressure. Down goes McGraw and gets shoved for his trouble. Lou Super falls down at the hands of Sergeant Slaughter. Rick McGraw being taken out of the ring area now by the attendants. He is wobbly. And there goes the pressure against the head and neck again. Okay, there you saw it. And there you have the decision that we didn't even hear the bell. There was no bell indicating end of the wrestling there, but it is clearly over. And I'm telling you, fans, we have seen it tonight. Total surprise. Okay, coming up tonight, the main event, the championship match we've been waiting for, the return of George the Animal Steel. This play's going to come apart at the seams when he comes on the scene, versus Bob Backlund. Professional boxing from Atlantic City Sands Hotel, Marvin Stinson versus Randall Tex Cobb. That'll be on June 30th at 8:30 p.m. Watch it on Prism. Fans, I'll tell you, I've been seeing a lot of these matches for about 4 years here at the Spectrum. But tonight, I don't know, I keep saying I've seen it all, but have I really? Here he comes, George the Animal Steel. Let's look to the right. First is returned to the Spectrum in about 4 years, 1 year rather, and here he comes. There he comes on the scene. Not wrapped too tight, but who's going to tell him? Would he know what you're talking about? George the Animal Steel going for the championship belt tonight against Bob Backlund. Well, I'll tell you, Bob Backlund had better be in shape. We know he is, but he better be ready at full concentration tonight. Look, there he is. Who knows what's going on in that mind? Oh, look. All right. The animal being badgered by the ringsiders. I don't know that he's really aware of what's happening. He just knows he's waiting for somebody to show up in the ring, whoever he is. We know it's Backlund. He's not too sure, maybe. Just waiting for Backlund to come on. Whoever's coming on, he'll take him on. It doesn't matter to him. All right, maybe Backlund coming on the scene now. The fans responding. Okay. Led by Arnold Skolin. There he is. Oh, the animal going after Bob Backlund right off the bat. Backlund not even in the ring yet. The animal, just that. Backlund taking off his wrestling jacket outside the ring because he knows when he steps in there, he better be ready. And off comes the belt. Backlund is ready now. Backlund's still not in the ring, but he's...
There you go.
All right. Steele says, hey, you, hey. He doesn't have much in the way of vocabulary. Oh! Backlund reaching down. He'll pick up the steps and throw them at him. He doesn't care. Dick Worley.
Intermission and refreshment time follows this championship match.
Backlund still isn't even close to getting into the ring at this time. George Steele. Dick Worley is the third man.
239 pounds. Blue trunks. Come in. Bob Backlund.
All right, Bob Backlund.
One for the finish.
Backlund's moving around the other side of the ring. He's trying to find another way in because Steele won't. Whoa! Steele throws Dick Worley down to the canvas. Worley's starting to count on it. 3, 4, 5. Steele, we can't even begin this. All right, they're both outside the ring now. Woo! Now Backlund's inside the ring. Threw two seats up at one time in the ring. And the crowd has gone crazy. Fans of ringside are standing. They don't want to miss any of this because Steele is totally unpredictable and now he's coming our way. He's looking for anything. Arnold Skolin, manager of Backlund. Steele started to go out the wrong way out to the dressing room, started to chase the fans. All right, whoa! Did I say tonight that Sergeant Slaughter and Rick McGraw were in a war? I don't know, fans. I got to take that back. A sign was thrown in the ring by Steele. It came apart. Now Backlund has part of it. George is... Oh, there's that green tongue. What crazy body chemistry he has. Backlund very clearly in the ring indicating that Steele, come on, let's get it on. Backlund shoving aside Dick Worley. He wants that. Steele. Steele has the foreign object in his hand and shoves it in the midsection of Bob Backlund. Down he goes. I don't know where he has it. He has it in his mouth. That's where the foreign object is. Dick Worley tried to locate that object, couldn't find it.
They're going to go right on it here. Don't pull the more stuff.
All right, Steele slams Backlund into the turnbuckle. He's now pulling the turnbuckle apart. He's been known for that time and time again. He wants to slam Backlund's head against it. He's pulling at the other turnbuckle. Oh! He says from the inside packing, rubbing across the eyes of Bob Backlund. Oh, this man, he's a man. This person, I don't know, what do you say about him? Now a double hold on the neck area of Backlund, applying superhuman pressure. Backlund is really in trouble tonight. Here, oh, the pain taking over. Backlund almost in a sleeper hold. Dick Worley watching his eyes, checking on Backlund's face. Is he submitting or not? So far, no. George, the Animal Steel, clearly in control over champion Bob Backlund. We've seen a championship belt change hands tonight. Pedro Morales losing the belt to Magnificent Morocco. Maybe could happen tonight. Steele is more than maybe Backlund can handle for the time being. Still applying that pressure on the back of the neck of Backlund. Backlund trying to get it together, trying to get up. Fans at ringside yelling, come on, Bob, come on, Bob. You can hear them, you can watch them. They're very concerned right now. Steele still in control, still applying that animal pressure to the neck of Bob Backlund. Backlund trying desperately to get himself up. Dick Worley says, you concede. He says, no. Fans are standing on their seats at ringside, leaning over their seats, all over the spectrum. It's jammed with people tonight. Backlund on his feet again, trying to break the hold. Hans delivers a slam to the side of the head of Backlund. Backlund gets it back by Steele.
Get those hands up and up. Never mind that stuff.
All right. Worley warning Steele to open up that hand. No fist at all. Jumps at him, kicks at him. Now goes back to that pressure hold again on the top of the left shoulder. He's digging into those shoulder muscles. Arnold Skolin returns here tonight, the manager of Bob Backlund. He's sitting quietly, as he always does, at the Backlund's corner, watching events going on in the ring. But they've talked him. Whoa! There's that foreign object again. And Steele applying it to the pressure to Backlund. Worley counting him, counting three. Telling him to break the hold. Hey, First time in about a year that Steele's been back here at the Spectrum, this time against Backlund. Backlund is not in a position maybe to submit. Dick Worley looked over the corner of Backlund's to Arnold Skolin, asking him, does he submit? He said, no, no. All right. Skolin says to Worley, let him wrestle. Let him get up if he can. We'll lose that belt to him tonight. Backlund trying to get it up, trying to get it going. Steele with that superhuman strength now reaches in his trunks again for that third object. And down he goes, Backlund on the canvas once again. Steele saying, you get out of here, dude. Worley. Backlund in the corner now, getting smashed time and time again. Down he goes, getting kicked for his trouble. And the pressure on the neck of Backlund at the foot of Steele. Steele can count to three. He backs off, but goes with more pressure again with his hand. I'll tell you, Backlund's desperate tonight, fans. Backlund is still in trouble just about with it in the corner. Steele backed off, though. He's being talked to. Steele says to referee Dick Worley, you mean get out of here. Coming at him. Applying more pressure to the neck, the throat area of Bob Backlund.
I'm not going to keep telling you. You're going to go out of here.
They're urging Bob to get up. The ringsiders here, all the fans in the Spectrum tonight. I wouldn't want him looking at me saying, you. I'd say, yes, sir, what do you need? There, he's smashing it back on again. Another chop, third chop. All right. Worley warning Steele away. Oh. Steele cutting and chopping at Backlund. Backlund getting upset now. He's upset. He's going at Backlund. Backlund still taking a beating, but Backlund going after him. He's smashing at it. Backlund going after Steele. Backlund now pummeling Steele. Backlund going after him. And now Backlund taking a shot and he goes down. Backlund lying on the canvas. Here's a look at it. That foreign object in the mouth of Steele. A ringside cameraman very alertly got it. While Dick Worley's checking out the wrestling attire of George the Animal Steele, trying to find that object. Didn't do it. But still, meanwhile, Backlund still on the canvas, trying to get up. He knows he could lose that belt tonight.
Get out of there! Hey!
There goes a forearm chop to the back of the head, and there goes those hands digging into the neck muscles and the shoulder muscles of Bob Backlund. Backlund can't take too much or more of this. Now, he's in superb condition. Tremendous athlete, but how much can he take? He's not just dealing with a man, he's dealing with an animal. Backlund striving to get back up again. Plants one foot. Grabs the arm of Steele, gets the other foot up there. Now standing on both feet, now he headbutts Steele. Steele back again, working on that upper arm area. People yelling at ringside, let's go, Bob. Let's go, Bob. And they're trying to infuse him with their energy and strength as he tries to get back on his feet. He seems to be back now, but headbutts the animal. Headbutts him again. Smashes at him. Smashes at him again. Steele goes down. Steele hung up on the rope, and the fans go crazy. Now Backlund starts to shake Steele. All right, a count of four, a count of five. Backlund does break the hold. He wants to shake Steele apart now. And Steele on the ring apron, just barely on there. Being kicked at by Backlund. Outside the ring he goes. the fence work surrounding the Spectrum ring. Steele hanging on, barely. He's pulling the fence apart. Oh, he has somebody's umbrella, I think. Animal Steele has somebody's umbrella. He's coming in the ring with it now. Smashes him in the middle. Smashes him again. Smashes him on the head. Down goes Steele. Brings it over his arm. Bending it over his arm. Oh, he caught him. Steele lashed out and caught back, I think. Between the legs. Count. They're both down. Here comes Steele at Backlund again, smashing at him with that foreign object, driving him down to the canvas again. Steele is just mauling the champion. There he goes with a shot to the neck area, the throat. There he goes. One, two, three. Here comes Steele. A chair thrown in the ring by Steele. And I'll tell you, Steele has gone crazy. I guess he'd call it that. Backlund clearly the winner, and a quick turn of events, but I'll tell you, it's been a brawl tonight. We'll see if we get Bob and his manager, Arnold Skolin. They have that foreign object. Bob!
And this, ladies and gentlemen,
all right, Bob. Okay, no interview. Bob went off. No interview with Bob Backlund. He's terribly upset. He did maintain his belt. He hasn't. But let's check to see the events leading up to the decision again. Here we have it. All right. Steele is on at Backlund again, grabbing him by the hair with that foreign object, smashing him down again. Dick Worley warning him. Okay, let's watch now. He still has that foreign object, sliding it back. No, he still has it in the right hand. Gives Backlund a shot to the neck. Backlund moves off to the side of the ring. And now George Steele is shoved into the ring, turnbuckled by Backlund. Backlund comes down on him. There's the pin. One, two, and three. And there's the decision, folks. And I'm telling you, whew, I need an intermission, don't you? Okay, intermission time, folks. We'll be back shortly. Intermission time featuring an interview I did earlier with Sergeant Slaughter. Also, Prison's Wrestling Fan of the Month will be announced, in addition to a new feature, the Wrestling Rating. But first, here's some scenes from the great Santini.
Robert Duvall is the great Santini.
Fiddle, fiddle, time to get up in the morning.
But you are Marine kids and can chew nails while other kids are sucking cotton candy.
Dad! Hey, Lily, the little homo's sleeping naked.
You're Meacham's. Beats him as a thoroughbred, a winner all the way.
Hey, have a Dutch sports car.
Hey. Meacham never gives up. Do you read me loud and clear?
Yes, sir.
I was praying we'd all go to war again, so King Kong out there could fight somebody besides me.
Ah, he does what he does because he loves you and he wants you to be the best.
You disobeyed the direct order, Hawk. A direct order from your commanding officer.
Yes, sir.
Being a warrior without a war has its problems.
You may love him, you may hate him, but you'll never forget the great Santini. The bravest thing he would ever do was let his family love him.
This is Dick Graham at intermission. I'm about to announce the winner of Prism's Wrestling Fan of the Month. It was selected at random from the Prism Wrestling Fan Club. If you're not a member of the fan club, you want to join, here's what you do. Just send your name and address to Prism Wrestling Fan Club, in care of the Spectrum, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19148. This month's winner is George Giovanelli of Clifton Heights, Pennsylvania. George is going to receive Prism t-shirts and tickets to Spectrum Wrestling on Saturday, August 1st. Congratulations, George. Now, here's that address once again if you want to join. Prism Wrestling Fan Club, in care of the Spectrum, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19148. Coming up next is an interview with Sergeant Slaughter. But first, let's take a look at a movie returning to Prism in July, Skateboard.
From the streets to the meets. Yay! Skateboard brings a new kind of motion to the screen. There's comedy, craziness, love at every speed. Skateboard has it all.
Yay! This is the final and greatest event, the great 1 mile downhill.
Yay! Have the kid take a dive.
I ain't telling no kid to take a dive, Sully.
You weren't scared. The guy from Brewer threatened me.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
What? He threatened me.
If I don't get that 10 grand, you're dead.
The craziest kids on wheels.
Nothing's too good for this team.
Skateboard, the movie that defies gravity.
Well, the intermission guest tonight is somebody whom you have seen many, many times. Those of you who watch Prism Wrestling from the Spectrum, and I don't know how much I can really say about him, just the showing his face and the wrestling attire gives you the message. This is a really rough customer by the name of Sergeant Slaughter. The fellow spent a lot of time in the service, and he carried over the feeling of discipline and strength and pain and aggressiveness from the service days into the present time with the wrestling. And Sergeant Slaughter, he does it very well, don't you think? A lot of folks don't like him, but I'll tell you, you've got to agree, you can't be neutral about this guy. Sergeant Slaughter, welcome to Prism Television tonight.
Well, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. I know that your rating time is now, and that's why you asked me to be here. You're trying to get your ratings up, and I know guys like you, you try to do things like that.
Okay, anything you want to think, it's okay with me.
Well,
right.
You know, I put down offers by Johnny Carson and Tom Snyder and Douglas just to have this interview with you.
Hey, that's class, right? Class gentleman. Really, talking about it, he started wrestling back in the days of high school, got in the service and wrestled there, and then decided to continue it on after he got out of the service. And he just, as a matter of fact, came back from four long weeks of wrestling in Japan, you told me about.
Yes, it was very rough, very strenuous. I learned a lot of things. I've been chasing Bob Backlund all over the country. Bob Backlund went to Japan, so I went to Japan.
You went to Japan.
I asked the general, the Grand Wizard, for a leave of absence, and he gave it to me for 4 weeks, but we still haven't caught Backlund.
Well, what have you learned over there wrestling the Japanese wrestlers, if any, that you think you can use against Backlund or anybody else in the future as far as that's concerned?
Well, they have a lot of pressure holes. They wanted to know about me, the Cobra Clutch. They wanted to know how does that work, and I just want to let them know.
Well, we're going to talk about that tonight. You've got a $5,000 offer going now. Can you tell us about that?
Any wrestler or a fan, if they want to put their life on the line, should I say. I want to step in the ring and allow me to put the Cobra Clutch on. $5,000 to anybody who can break it.
If they can break it, they get $5,000.
That's right. Unless you're Pat Patterson, who I offered $10,000 to, because my manager, the general, the Grand Wizard, doesn't like him, and he put up another $5,000, and he has a chance for $10,000.
Let's say he doesn't like him, but why 10? I mean, that's a lot of money, and it's out of your pocket, for heaven's sake.
Well, $10,000, we didn't think Patterson would budge on $5,000, so we thought if we upped the money, he might come out from behind that desk and get into the ring with me.
Listen, for 20, even maybe even for 5, I'll go with you. You know, you could
do it. Oh, we
could
do it right now.
No, thanks. Just talking about it. Just talking out loud, you know. Okay, you're a guy who likes discipline. I'll tell you one thing. I've watched you numerous times here at the Spectrum. You like to inflict a lot of pain on whoever you wrestle, and that's your style.
Well, that's the way I taught it, and that's the way I do it. Do unto others before they do it to you. That's
your carryover from the service
days,
huh?
That's what we taught in boot camp. I taught a lot of men out there, the few, the proud, I can't say what I was, but if you're a few and a proud one, you know you were in the boot camp with me or one of my associates, and you know that you're a man right now if you were a Marine.
Well, you know, I always watch you wrestling. You always seem to get a great deal of pleasure out of putting a big hurt on your opponent, and that gives you personal pleasure, doesn't it?
I enjoy it. Some guys like to wrestle by the rules. I wrestle by the rules, but I bend them a little bit. I take advantage of the rules, and I admit it. I admit I break the rules, and I bend the rules, and I enjoy it, like the man says. He's seen me in action, and he knows.
What's your biggest goal? And I wrestled Backlund here at the Spectrum, and of course you wrestled Madison Square Garden. As far as you know right now, what would be the biggest goal you could ever have in wrestling? Or have you achieved that already?
No, I've achieved one goal, was to get Bob Backlund into the ring, but now my goal is to beat him and get the title. I've tried numerous times here at the Spectrum, but the coward keeps running. We had a match here in that steel cage, and he ran out of that. So I don't know how I'm going to get him back into the ring.
So that's your goal, to get the belt then?
To get the belt and to get Bruno Sammartino out of retirement. Ever since I came here, not only to Philadelphia, but all over this area, Bruno Sammartino went into a semi-retirement, and I can't figure it out. I'd like to get him out of his cobwebs and get him into the ring.
Well,
along with Pat Patterson.
Looks like Sergeant Slaughter has thrown the gauntlet down once again to Bruno Sammartino and Bob Backlund. So I guess he has a standing offer to take these gentlemen on any time he can arrange his own time, and they can arrange their time. Well, that's our interview for tonight, Sergeant Slaughter. It's good to get kind of next to him and get to see the other side of him a little bit when we're not in a squared circle, of course. Coming up next is a new feature, the wrestling ratings. But first, here are some scenes from Escape from Alcatraz.
Let's try that Cobra Clutch.
Oh, gun, 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 gun.
This is Frank Morris. Armed robbery, burglary, grand larceny. Morris has escaped from many prisons, but Alcatraz could be the exception.
This island is solid rock. No one's ever busted out. No one's ever made it.
Since I've been warden, a few people have tried to escape. Most of them have been recaptured. Those that haven't have been killed.
I may have found a way out of here.
No one has ever escaped from Alcatraz.
I'm in. Me too.
And no one ever will.
Shake down.
The bulls count us, and the king bulls count the counts.
No one has ever escaped from Alcatraz. And no one ever will.
See you later, man.
Goodbye.
And no one ever will.
In 1962, that statement was no longer valid. Clint Eastwood is Frank Morris in Escape from Alcatraz.
Wrestling fans, before the action resumes, let's take a look at the World Wrestling Federation ratings for the month of July. And here they are. Of course, leading the entire pack would be everybody's favorite, the champion, Bob Backlund. Then in order, the next 10 would be Stan Hansen, King Kong Mosca, sort of a rough guy to deal with. Everybody, of course, loves number 3, and that would be Pedro Morales, the Continental Champion. Magnificent Morocco, he's from Hawaii, and he's just beginning to make the scene here in Philadelphia and along the East Coast. Sergeant Slaughter, well, what can you say about him? He's mean all the way through, and everybody knows about him. Mil Mascaris, a very fine wrestler in his own right, very popular here in Philadelphia and wherever he wrestles, as well as Pat Patterson, holding down the number 7 slot. Then we move to popular Rick Martel, a young guy who's just as clean-cut as can be, and all the ladies, of course, like him. They don't think too much of Killer Khan, though. We know he's nasty as can be. But holding down the last slot, a very popular wrestler from the New Zealand area, is Tony Garea. So there's the 10. What do you think about the order of the appearance, huh? Do you like it, or do you disagree? Those are the ratings for the month of July. Before we return to the squared circle, let's see who Jim Barniak interviews this month on Sports Scrapbook.
We're going to talk bowling on my next edition of Sports Scrapbook, but just a little bit. We're going to talk a lot about baseball. This is the Del Ennis Lanes in Northeast Philadelphia, and the proprietor, Del Ennis, of course, one of the great all-time RBI men in baseball history. Be sure and join Del Ennis and me. We'll talk about the good old days with the Phillies and life here with the Fast Lane. Oh, join us anyway.
Well, fans, believe it or not, things are rather quiet here after all that early evening craziness, because I'll tell you, here at the Spectrum, let's get the decision on here from Gary Capetta, the ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the match, 11 minutes, 29 seconds. The winners in still World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Rex Spot, the Moondogs.
All right, they maintain their belt. They maintain the championship. Rex and Spot go off now. The fans needling them. However, S.D. Jones and Dominic still rather shocked at the turn of events here. They thought they had a good shot themselves at the tag team championship, but not tonight. All right, fans, check your screen. Here we go, the instant replay, courtesy of Prism. Rex Moondog slammed into the ropes. He springs off. Zanucci goes grabbing for him. All right, puts him into what we thought we had a submission hold. However, Spot Moondog comes on the scene while the referee's tangling with S.D. Jones. Here comes Spot leaping ahead with a forearm smash down to the back of Dominic DeLucci. He rolls down. Rex Moondog rolls right over on him, and the referee comes over, and there you have one, two, and three. Well, fans, the excitement's not over. We still have more, would you believe? Can you take it tonight? We still have more, because the next event will be long in just a minute. All right, let's pick up on the events for next month. Here's Gary Capetta.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next card of championship wrestling set for the Philadelphia Spectrum is set for Saturday evening, August the 1st. That's Saturday, August the 1st. And ladies and gentlemen, listen to this. The special attraction Saturday, August the 1st, will be a 20-man over-the-top battle royal. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the match begins with 20 heavyweight wrestlers in the ring. Each entrant will be eliminated only when he is tossed out of the ring, falling to the hard arena floor. The last wrestler in the ring will be declared the winner of the match, and he will receive a check in the amount of $10,000. In addition, Saturday, August 1st, the winner of the 20-man over-the-top battle royal will receive a crack at the title of the World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, Bob Backlund. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the entrants already signed for the Battle Royal Saturday, August the 1st, are George the Animal Steele. He will be joined by the Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales. Rick McGraw. Also, the Magnificent Morocco. Mongolia's Killer Khan. The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Spot and King, the Moondogs. Also, Special Delivery Jones, Kurt Henning, Dominic DeNucci, Pretty Boy Larry Sharp, Strong Kobayashi, Baron Miguel Cicluna, The Unpredictable Johnny Roz, also Chris Cannon, Rick Martel, Dick the Bulldog Brower, Tony Garea, King Kong Maska, and Andre the Giant. gentlemen, in addition to the 20-man over-the-top battle royal and the heavyweight title defense, there will be 9 bouts to follow. But that's not all, ladies and gentlemen. Saturday, August the 1st, a special return match. It is being billed as an alley match. No rules, no referee, anything goes. It will be between Sergeant Slaughter and Pat Patterson. Now, ladies and gentlemen, promoter Phil Zacco has gone to great lengths putting together this card for Saturday, August the 1st. I advise you to pick up your tickets early here at the Spectrum box office at all Ticketron locations. Saturday, August 1st, back here at the Spectrum.
Well, fans, I don't know. Phil Zacco does it again. I thought we'd seen it all tonight, but listen. 20-man battle royal. The winner is the person last standing in the ring. 9 matches to follow. Woo! Well, let's get it on. Here he comes, the captain. The Captain Lou Albano. Captain Lou in the ring. And of course, he'll be going against the very popular wrestler from Quebec City, Rick Martel. Fans, we've got it all coming up on August 1st. Be here. What a great night coming up. Andre the Giant's return. Here's Rick Martel into the ring. Oh, is he ready? Let's get the announcement, huh?
Ladies and gentlemen, the following bout is set for one fall with a 30-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left from Carmel, New York, 281 pounds, the guiding light, Captain Louis Albano. And wrestling fans, his opponent this evening from Quebec City, Canada, 244 pounds, Rick Martel.
Well, there you have it, fans. This is our big windup tonight. Don't go away, Captain Lou. And this is a grudge match against Martel, and it's underway already. Martel being stung around the eyes by Captain. You know he's not going to do anything right. And outside the ring goes Martel. And he feels that he is champion. He's in charge. The Captain. Captain Lou. Martel outside the ring. He was smashed across the eyes by Albano. And Martel outside the ring again. He crashes against the barrier, this wrought iron barrier around our ring area. Martel, he's hurting. Smashed his arm against the fence, as we said. He's still favoring that one arm, but Captain Lou keeps right on top of him, smashes him. Oh, into the ring post. Boy, that's all metal, solid metal. Help holding this ring area together. He goes crashing into it. Down he goes, being helped to his feet by some fans. Martel still stunned, trying to get himself back in the ring again. Albano waiting for him to get even close by, and here he goes. Albano right on top of him again, raking the eyes again. I don't know whether Martel's going to be able to see or not. Here's Captain Lou. Captain Lou with a piece of the wrapping from his hand there, of his wrist area, unravels some of the adhesive tape and runs that across the eyes of Rick Martel. He really cannot see. I don't know what He's favoring his eyes, and the world must be a blur to him. And still working on the eyes is Albano. Albano, when he's in control, everything's fine. When he's not, the cowardly lion. Martel just swinging at air. He doesn't even know where Albano is. Oh, he does it again. Wrapping the adhesive tape around his wrist again. Dusty Feldbaumer didn't, or Lou Supa didn't see that at the moment. And he kicks out. Kicks out again. And now, into the turnbuckle goes Captain Lou's head. All right, that adhesive tape is off the wrist of Albano, and now it's around the neck of Albano. And punching Albano out is Rick Martel. Lefts and rights and lefts and rights. A series of lefts. He's got a chokehold on him now. Albano has no place to run, folks. Here goes that adhesive tape around his neck again. Albano in bad trouble. The fans don't care. He'd like to give up. He rolls outside the ring. And goes off. I don't know. Is this the end of it? He's taken off. There's a count of two by Lou Supa. Count of three. Count of four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. That's it. Martel not really liking this turn of events. But Captain Lou splits like a big bird. All right, here's Gary Capetta with the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time for the match, 4 minutes, 5 seconds. The winner on a count out, Rick Martel.
All right, Rick Martel going off. And he barely broke a sweat tonight. I thought we'd see a little more action, but the Captain Lou Albano had quite enough. He was all right for a while there, but he was giving it but good to Martel, but suddenly it turned against him, and predictably the Captain can't take the heat. He gets out of the kitchen. Okay, so that's about it. All right. Well, fans, you heard the word earlier. Gary Capetta, our ring announcer, mentioned the fact that we've got a great card coming up on August the 1st, on Saturday night, and I hope you're going to be here, because nothing's going to keep me from being here. I want to see all the action, a 20-man over-the-top free-for-all battle royal. And the winner, the guy who's left standing after all that, will receive $10,000. I guess that's out of the pocket of Phil Zacco, the promoter. Good for Phil. Anyway, that's going to happen. Bob Backlund's going to be back. He's taking on his opponent. And I'll tell you, a lot more is happening. Sergeant Slaughter is going to return against Quick Draw Rick McGraw. We're going to have Andre the Giant returning. Can we stand it? I'll tell you, lots happening here, fans. Every Saturday night, we have wrestling at the Spectrum. Every month, we invite you to come on by and see it all. It's crazy action, but that's what we love. That's what we come to expect. That's what we get. Well, for Cal Rudman, my buddy, he's out on the West Coast. As we said earlier tonight, maybe you missed it. Cal's seeing his son graduate from UCLA over the weekend. So he'll be back here on August 1st. I'll have to fill him in by telephone as to what he can expect when he returns with us next August the 1st, our next Saturday Night Wrestling here at the Spectrum. You've been great. Those of you watching from Prism TV, watching along the Prism Television Network, great to have you with us. Next time, come on down and enjoy all this wonderfulness in person. For the crew here at the Prism Network tonight, of course, we've got a great camera selection by Bob Ayers and Randy Seidman producing. Rest of the gang, my old buddy goes way, way back with me, crazy Ralphie Hicks. We've got Vince, Pete, and Scott, and all the rest of them. A great crew here bringing you all the exciting action at the Spectrum. That's all from Dick Graham. Have a good weekend and a wonderful month, everybody.